hike and having a traffic jam like this is never a bad thing. It's so gorgeous out here.
Hi everybody! Ren and I are out for another morning walk. We're considering this our vitamin D, dose of vitamin D, taking our dogs out. And we had to do some errands over in White Sulphur today, so we decided to just take a walk out on one of the kind of dirt roads through the pastures. We used to meet our friends out here as well. It's really nice and the scenery is gorgeous today. And our dogs are needing a good stretch, so we're all taking our time and kind of enjoying it in between the errands, and got to see a lot of the calves. It's calving season. A lot of babies on the road on the way over here. And here's kind of our scenery, what we're looking at as we're walking. It's absolutely gorgeous. Even though there's gray sky and clouds, it's breathtaking. I always love it out here. And these are the backside of the Bridger. Bozeman's just on the other side. So one of the things that Ren and I like to do when we have the dogs out, especially if it's on a road like this where there's no traffic and it's pretty rural, is to just practice our recalls. It's fun for the dogs. They kind of get to open up and fly, and it's fun for us, and it just keeps our training kind of fresh. So Ren, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, take off, bub. So we're just gonna let Ren take off. And then when we're ready, we just start calling the dogs randomly back and forth. And I think it's actually good exercise for Ren, too, to run out there. Seeker's so sweet. Wherever the kids go, he paces perfectly right beside them. He loves the kids so much. Here's my crew. And I'm going to go down the dirt road quite a ways. And then I'm going to call them. Ren, I'm calling you, too. You going to try to run fast?
Yeah.
Are you?
Yeah.
Who do you think you can beat?
Definitely not Seeker or Ocean.
Definitely not. You know, I think for me, and my kids have been hiking and working with the dogs since before they were even born, when they were in my tummy. They've been doing this. But for me, getting out with my dogs isn't just about wearing them out or getting them exercise so I can get on with my day. This is the part of my day I think I look forward to the most, actually, because it's just lots of fresh air and mind clearing, and I can feel myself relax every time we get in the car to drive somewhere, and I know I get to get out and walk with my dog. So it's never felt like a chore. Ren, has it ever felt like a chore to you?
No.
No. And it's never felt like a chore. In fact, it's the part of my day that I think I look forward to the most. And I try to schedule the whole rest of my day around what we do with our dogs. And I kind of, when we decided to get working breeds, almost, it was 16, 17 years ago, we made a decision that we would make the time in our day and be available to work them because they are working breeds, and not just give them the leftover time of our day. But I think it doesn't hurt to take walks in Montana.
And there's my beautiful Franny. There she is.
Puppies, come! There they are! Hi, guys! Hello! Here come the grandma girls! Here they come! Hi, beautifuls! How are you? Hello! Hi, Fran, you did it. Here comes Ren. So when we're out just on the dirt road, you know, it's kind of fun for us is not to just walk the dirt road and do nothing but to interact with our dogs and let them interact with the environment. This is Seeker's favorite thing, is kind of cruising in irrigation ditches and puddles. And Ocean's always looking for mice, always. But to play recalls and play games and find it and just to make a short kind of dirt road walk really interactive, you know. It's good for all of us. And who doesn't like a muddy dog? Okay, and one of the things we do is if I run away, they should come. So we'll see if this works. Ready? Let's go, hurry! And Ray picked up his leash on the way back. Good boy. Good boy. That was awesome. That was awesome. Seeker, come! Hurry! Hurry, hurry! Who is that? Who is that? Who is that? Hi, you! Hi, beautiful! You ready?
And my feeling is if you take your dog's leash off, that you're kind of telling everyone around you that you and your dog have a strong enough relationship where if you call them or ask them for a remote down, they'll give it to you. So it looks something like this. So my dogs are over here on the side. Story down. Nice. And that kind of down is just kind of a down weight. Seeker, come. Hurry. And if I call my dog, I expect them to come. Seeker, right here. Nice. What a good boy. Good boy. And if I stand still and I'm not doing too much, my dog should kind of be milling in my space and not taking off. And that's when I know my dogs are ready to be off leash. So that's kind of how we gauge that.
Come on, guys, let's go.
Nice. And then when we kind of move as a team. We're all just kind of going in the same direction together. And I'll show you again. Story down. Seeker, lie down. Nice. And I'm about, what do you say, around 30 feet? About 30 feet away. Okay, let's go, guys. Good. And that's what it should look like. You know, when you take your dog off leash, if you call them, they should come. They should be within 20 to 30 feet of you at all times. Closer is better if it's a busy trail. If you need to, you need to be able to take them out of motion, so you have to have a remote down. And that would be part of the Montana Mud Month. So whenever we're getting close to the trailhead or close to our car, if we're parked off the side of the road or something, we always put our leashes on. It's just super cheap insurance. So that's generally Ren's job. And all of our dogs like their leashes, which is really kind of a handy thing. Go ahead and get Seeker. Come on, Story. Oh, good. Come here. And I'll have Ocean. Come here, Posh. Good girl, let's get that leash. Nice. And then we go to the car together and I know everybody's safe, which is the gig when we're ending a walk or a hike, because we don't want a silly accident that could have been prevented.